Hello friends and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to introduce you to the concept of hashing. First, let's consider a general problem. We have an employee management system where we store employee records indexed according to their telephone numbers. This is a kind of records that we want. Here, each row is uniquely identified through the telephone number of the employees. Now, for this, we define three operations. We will be adding new employee records, we will be searching for employee records through their telephone numbers, and we will be deleting employee records. Now the question is, how to implement this problem such that all the three given operations are done in most efficient manner? Let's consider a few solutions. The first one is using an array. We can store them in an array, but then searching a record will require linear time as we have to go through all the records until the required one is found. An improvement in search can be made if we store them in a sorted manner. In that case, search can be done using binary search method, which takes big O of log n time. But then insertion and deletion will become costly as we need to maintain the sorted order. Next method is to use a linked list. Here also we require a linear time to search for a particular record as we need to go through all the records until the required one is found. The next approach is using balanced binary search trees. The use of balanced binary search trees makes sure that we achieve a complexity of big O of log n for all three operations. Next method is to use a direct access table. This method provides an efficient complexity of big O of 1 for all three operations. Let's see how it looks like. This is an example of direct access table. Here telephone number acts as a key and the value stores the address of the record. These are the records. This method looks good, but it also suffers certain limitations. The first limitation is the size of table. The extra space required is big O of m into 10 to the power n, where m is the size of pointer to the record and n are the digits in the telephone number. The other limitation is that the digits in the telephone number can be more than what our integer variable can store. We'll try to improve this method and simultaneously introduce you to the concept of hashing. As of now, know that hashing provides big O of one time for insertion, search, and delete operation. We'll need a black box that takes a phone number and convert it into a less digit number. This black box will be called as hash function. So a hash function maps a big number or string to a small integer that can be used as index in hash table. Let's take an example of hash function. We define a hash function h of x, which is x modulo 7. Here x is our input number. Let's take a couple of examples. If x is this number, our h of x will give result as 4. If x is this, doing it modulo 7 will give 5. See how our hash function is mapping such a big number to a single digit number. This function is okay, but certainly not a good choice to be a hash function. Let's see few properties of a good hash function. The first property is that the hash function should compute things efficiently. This is obvious as we do not want to spend our resources on something which has nothing to do with the outcome. The second property is that the hash function should uniformly distribute the keys. That is, each table position is equally likely for each key. Now, since we have seen hash function, it's time to see collision due to it. For the same hash function, these are the two examples which yields the same key, that is 4. Hence, a collision can occur as for two different telephone numbers, we are getting the same values. This collision creates trouble for our hash function. However, things can still be controlled. Yes, that's right. This collision can be handled, and we have a couple of techniques for it. The first one is called chaining. Here, each cell of hash table points to a linked list which has all the records with the same hash function value. The next technique is open addressing. In this, we devise method so that all the elements are stored in hash table itself. Open addressing is again divided into three types: linear probing, quadratic probing, and double hashing. We'll cover both these methods in detail in separate videos. For this video, we end it here. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.